So in the continuation of last class, we will see the second problem of Singh equation. The question is given as a 50 Hz generator unit as H constant of 2 mJ by mVA. The machine is initially operating in steady state at synchronized speed and producing 1 per unit of real power. The initial value of rotor angle is 5 degree. The initial value of rotor angle is 5 degree. When a 3-phase to ground short circuit fault occurs at the terminal of the generator, assuming the input power to remain at 1 per unit, find the value of delta in degree at 0.02 second after the fault is occurrence. So this problem is also very similar to the last problem. Here all the values are given in per unit. Last problem, it is actual values. So by seeing this problem, we have the value of H constant, that is inertia constant, of 2 mg, mj per megawatt ampere. And also they are telling the machine is at steady state only. Before the fault is occurred, it is a steady state and also maintaining the synchronized speed and producing 1 per unit of real power. And they have given delta naught. Delta naught is what? The initial angle between. Rotor angle is nothing but with reference to the stator, the angle is 5 degree. So initially delta naught, this is nothing but delta naught value. So delta naught value is 5 degree. Some fault is occurred. Some 3-phase to ground fault is, short circuit fault is occurred. So fault is occurred. We need to find out how much deviation is happened in delta. So initially delta is 5 degree. After fault, what is the delta? You need to find out in degree only. Sometimes they may ask in radian. Just convert degree into radian and you can put the value. Here they are not given the cycles. How many number of cycles they didn't give? But directly they have given the T value. So T value is 0.02 second. That is nothing but 20 millisecond. So obviously it is first cycle. Correct or not? Why? Because the frequency is 58. So 1 divided by 50 is 0.02 millisecond. That is nothing but 1 cycle time. So during first cycle, what is the value we need to find out? And after the fault occurs, we need to find out the value for first cycle. One more thing you need to importantly consider here, the acceleration power is constant. Why I am telling acceleration power is constant is because they're telling that the mechanical power is not changed. The mechanical power is not changed after the problem is occurred. So what we need to do is PA before and after we need to find out. So check for PA after before the fault is nothing but PA is equal to PM minus PE. So this is the thing. And we know that what is the electrical power it is producing? What is the electrical power it is producing? 1 per unit. Correct or not? So before fault, I can write BF is nothing but before fault. And I will write after fault. AF after fault, PA is equal to again PM minus PE. But after fault, we know that PA is not at all equal to 0. Before fault, we know that PA must be equal to 0. Then only under steady state we can call. So in steady state, under steady state at synchronized speed, it producing the electrical power 1 per unit. So I will write like this. PA is equal to 0. So I can write straight away 0 is equal to PM minus 1. Correct or not? 1 is what? Electrical power. So what will be my PM value? PM value is also 1. Then only 1 minus 1 will get cancelled and PA will be 0. Same condition applied after fault. My PA is not at all equal to 0. I know that. So I want to find out the PA value. And also they are telling, assuming the input mechanical power remains 1 per unit. Remains 1 per unit means there is no any change in mechanical power. Only electrical side some fault is occurred. So I will put one in the mechanical side, and electrical fault is, it is a fault. Definitely it is a fault. There is no any electrical power for me. So my electrical power, this value becomes zero. So I will put zero here. Therefore, my PA value is equal to one. I got value of PA is equal to one. And we all know that the formula is, after fault, I need to find out del T is equal to 1 divided by 2 alpha T square. So this is the value I need to find out. So for alpha, I got the value. I got the value for PA. And then now I need to find out the value for M. So how we can find out M value? M is equal to, we know that in per unit, I don't want to put base. So I will remove G. Instead of GH, GH divided by 180 into F. G I don't want, because I need only in per unit. So base I don't want to write. This is base. So I don't want to multiply it with base. If I multiply it with base, then actual value I will get. So in per unit only, all the values are calculated. So M straight away I will write as 2. H value is 2 is given. So directly take H value as 2, 180 into 50. So what is the value of M? So what is the value of M? Please tell me. M in per unit. Because G is removed here, so all these values are per unit. Tell me the value. Very good. So it is 1 by 4500. Now what next? Can we go for alpha to find out alpha? So alpha is nothing but PA divided by M. So what is PA value? It is 1 divided by 4500. It is nothing but again 4500. So this is my alpha value. So I know what is time. Time is given in the question itself. Instead of cycle, they have given straight away the time value. And also I know the alpha value. Just apply it and then find out the value. And what is missing here? Del naught is missing, right? I will write here del naught plus. So what is del naught value? In this formula I missed del naught. So what is del naught value in the question they have given? That is before fault. What is the angle between rotor and stator? Someone tell me please from the question. Very good. So delta T is equal to 5 plus 1 divided by 2 into 4500 into 0.02 the whole square. So delta T value is equal to how much then? So what is the value of delta T? Very good. It is 5.9 in degree. They are asking in the degree, so I will write straight away in the degree. Now you can see that initially before the fault is occurred, the rotor angle is 5 degree, but after fault is occurred, my rotor angle is 5.9 degree. So 0.9 degree variation is happened. It is disturbing the system, so we need to do some action to regain to its position of 5 degree. Correct or not? So this is how the Singh equation will work out. Please note down this problem. Any doubt here? If you have any doubt, you can ask me now. Okay, thank you. So just a minute. Okay.